In this video lecture, we want to give a short introduction to the Random class, a Java-provided class which gives us random number generation capability. Okay, let's get started. The Random class can be used to generate random numbers in our programs. The numbers generated may appear random, but in reality they're actually pseudo-random, in that they are really mathematically calculated according to some algorithm. You can have a look at these details in the Random API if you're curious. Nonetheless, these numbers will be random enough for our purposes. The Random class is found in the java.util package of the Java API, so it first must be imported before it can be used. To use the Random class, as always, you would first instantiate a new random object, then call its various next methods to get some desired random number. There are multiple forms of the next methods, depending upon what data type of random numbers you're after. You can take a look at the API for the Random class to see all these, but we will primarily concern ourselves with the random integer forms. When all is said and done, a new random object is really just a random number generator in our programs. Let's take a look at how to create one, and then how to use it. Here on the top, we see the default constructor for the Random class. There are other constructors available, but this is the simplest one to use, and it will suffice for our purposes. Once we've created a new random object, here is the API method nextInt, which will return a random integer over a specified range. By definition, this method takes one integer input and returns a random int from 0 up to, but not including, the specified number. Again, there are additional similar API methods which can return random numbers of other data types, such as float or double, but we won't concern ourselves with these at this point. You can have a look at the Random API to see what other methods are available and how to use them. Notice that Random is an example of the typical style of object-based classes, in which we first need to create new objects of the specific class type. Here's an example of how to use the Random class to generate a random dice roll from 1 to 6. First, remember that you must import the Random class as shown here, and this statement would appear ahead of your program's class declaration. Next, as with any Java class, we first have to instantiate a new object of the desired class by using the new keyword and one of the available constructors. Here, we are declaring a new random object called dice and instantiating it using the default constructor, which takes no inputs and is the simplest way of quickly creating a new object. Finally, once we have this dice object on hand, then we can use it as a random number generator. Here we are calling the nextInt method to generate one of six possible random values ranging from 0 to 5, but not including 6. So this first term on the right is one random integer from 0 to 5. But since a dice roll must be from 1 to 6, we need to offset this term by 1. So now this entire right-hand side expression is a random integer from 1 to 6, and we simply assign it to a declared left-hand side variable, and that's all there is to it. So now that we've seen how to create a random number from 0 up to some specified limit, let's generalize that into generating random numbers over any specified range. Let's say that our desired range spans from m to n, including both those endpoints, and with m less than n. Here is the general form of using the Random class to generate a random integer over that specific range. We would first create a new random number generator object, which here is randobj, and then call its nextInt method with this indicated expression involving the desired endpoints, then offset that entire random number by m. Why does this work? Well, for the moment, we'll just need to take this on faith. But on the next slide, we'll take a look at the derivation of why this works. Here is an example of how we could generate a random number over the range 100 to 200. As always, we start by creating a new random object, or rand in this case, using the default constructor. Here then are the values for the minimum and maximum value parameters, 100 and 200. Then according to the general form shown above, we simply call the nextInt method with a maximum and minimum desired values, and then offset the result by the minimum value. At this point, I'd encourage you now to pause for a moment and view the short code walkthrough video for randomexamples.java. This example will show how to prompt for these minimum and maximum values and use them to generate a random number. You'll find this example in the usual place. Come back to this video when you are finished. It's good to have a nice simple formula showing how to compute something, but it's even better to understand how and why that formula works. Here's a derivation for that expression on the prior slide showing how to generate random numbers over a specific range. As a starting point, in step 1, let's start with the simplest form of generating a random number from 0 up to, but not including, the endpoint value n. This gives us n possible random values, and the code expression we'd need is given here. Note that we are assuming that our random number generator random object has been created and is called rand. So for example, if n is equal to 100, this will give us 100 possible random numbers from 0 to 99. In step 2, let's add the top endpoint to our possible random values. Now we have n plus 1 possible random values from 0 up to and now including n. And to implement this, all we need to do is add 1 to the prior expression in code. So now, for example, if n is still equal to 100, now we have 101 possible values from 0 up to 100 now. So far, so good. Finally, in step 3, let's generalize the prior result by shifting the entire range upwards by m. Now the range is unchanged, but generalized to this expression, n plus 1 minus m. We now have n plus 1 minus m possible random numbers, but now their range is from m to n inclusive. So in the next int method, we've simply replaced the term n plus 1 with n plus 1 minus m, or rearranged n minus m plus 1. Then we offset the entire result by m, and that leaves us with the general expression we saw on the prior slide. To convince ourselves of this, let's say that now n equals 200 and m equals 100. We still have the same 101 possible values using either of these expressions using the random number generator object, but now we've shifted the results up by m equals 100, which gives us 101 possible random ints from 100 to 200. You may want to pause for a minute to go over this again and convince yourself of its correctness, but this is the derivation for generating a random number over a specific range. Okay, that should be enough to get you started on generating random numbers using the Random class.